there, Cherie here from Cherie's Alchemy. Welcome back to Vlogmas Day 3. Well, it's very early morning. I'm getting an early start before the house gets loud and crazy. My daughter heads out to the airport this afternoon to head back to college in Atlanta. And so I'll have to get myself cleaned up and ready to take her out because I'm gonna run some errands after I drop her off at the airport. But really quickly, I want to get some projects done. And yes, my intention is in the next 3 hours is to get all this sewn up. If you want to see what I'm doing with all this fleece, stay tuned. What a day I had. Well, let me just tell you that I got done most of what I wanted to get done today. There are two blankets that I didn't get done. I ran out of time. As you can see by me having on the lighting, it is now evening because I got caught up in other things and wasn't able to get this portion of the video recorded. I had another video for Vlogmas actually planned that was pre-recorded, but then because of what I put up yesterday and the comments that you guys left about my project that I presented yesterday, I'm like, let me move this one thing ahead, which I hadn't recorded yet. So let me show you what I did today. So for me, this was about 2 hours of time cutting and pinning and doing all the things to have these be finished projects. And what this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 blankets. That's right, blankets. And the reason why I wanted to go ahead and skip ahead to this is because the way I sew these blankets is the same way that I showed you how to sew the napkins, the 2 different styles of napkins in my Vlogmas Day 2 video, okay? I did two blankets a third way, a different way, a very easy way. But it's very specific to you having a certain machine, which not everyone has. So I'm gonna zoom in and show you each of these blankets individually. Before I go, let me pop up on a screen real quick to let you guys know what I'm wearing today. This is a Vogue wrap dress pattern, also a really, really lovely and flattering wrap dress pattern. I actually wore this to my son's high school graduation this year. I love it. I never showed it here yet, and so I just want to let you guys know. And then yesterday, let me show you real quick the head-to-toe look of what I had on in day 2's video, because I forgot to put that clip in the video. You know this is my favorite wrap dress pattern. I've made this several times. It was really fun because I tagged Joanne Fabrics in this on Instagram, and they actually shared this picture on their Instagram stories, which was kind of cool. But yeah, love, love, love this wrap dress. Okay, so anyway, let's get to the blankets. Okay, so these first two blankets are very, very simply made. All I did was cut my fabric to the size that I wanted it to be, and I used my serger to just go around all 4 edges. You'll see here they have these little bits that I'll have to, I'm gonna put a little fabric glue on there to prevent that from raveling, let it dry, and then trim. You can also get a needle and thread and kind of hem that back through, but I don't bother with these kinds of blankets. And this blanket, actually all the blankets except for this one here, because this is a small one, I used a little over 2 yards of fabric so that the finished blanket can end up being the length of 2 yards, which is 36 times 36, which is what, 72 inches long. And then I used the width of the fabric with the, selvage cut off. So yeah, so these two blankets, I just serged the edge. So this is just a beautiful plaid. I will say whenever I make these fleece blankets, I go ahead and spend the extra money to get the anti-pill ones. I find that the lower quality fleeces, you know, you save $1 a yard, but after you wash them, you know, they just look so bad. And it's like you spent all this effort to make it, especially if you're giving it as a gift, you want it to wash and dry well and not get all peely. And so, and with the coupons and stuff like that that they have these days, honestly, you can get these. I mean, I probably paid, this is probably about $10 or $12 worth of fabric for this 2-yard long blanket, maybe even cheaper, because I bought a bunch of fleece at Joann's last year during their big probably Cyber Monday sale, and then I just had this sitting, supposed to make these last year and never did. I made this one here. This is more kind of a lap size blanket, and this is just for my son when he's chilling. He's 18, but he still likes Pokemon. He's a gamer, so this is just a blanket for him. He's gonna be like, Mom, why'd you tell everybody that? And then this next one I'm gonna show you is made like the single ply napkins. So I went through, I serged the edge because I have a serger, but oops, hey look, I didn't even get all this ones off, trims off. I'll go back and inspect all this because these are actually gonna be gifts for my family members. So I went through, serged the edge, and then just did that fold down miter corner technique that I showed you guys yesterday in that day 2 Vlogmas video for making the napkins. So that red and gold dot is just, this is basically like one big napkin. So same thing, this ends up being 2 yards long once it's sewn up. And I did that because these blankets are actually made for us to use in our movie theater. And we stretch out, and you want to have like your whole body and your feet covered, right? Find that a lot of the ones you buy in the stores, they're just too short. You know, you have your feet sticking out and you're cold. This one here, I got the snowflake print, is clearly winter, but not only Christmas, right? And then I did the red minky on the back of this one. This one is for me. This is the print I picked for me. This is Cherie's blanket. And these, I should say, these last three that I'm showing you, these were all made with the method that I showed you for the 2-ply napkin. So it's 2 pieces of fabric, right size facing. These are so wide and so big that I did have to lay these on the cutting board. I have a really big cutting table, so I lay them on my cutting table. I can walk all around it. I pin it. If you don't have a large cutting table, you might have to do this on the floor or a dining room table, because you do want to make sure the fabrics are flat, right size facing, then pin it. And then I left that opening like I showed you in the day 2 Vlogmas video, turned it right side out, and then I just went around and top stitched. So these last three, the snowflake one that I showed you, that's going to be for my daughter. This one is a double side. I have the snowflake and I have this beautiful floral print. That one's for me. And then this is my son's, in addition to the Pokemon. That's more for just him chilling when he's sitting in his gaming chair and stuff. And this is his one for the movie theater. So again, he's a gamer. So I found this one that says game on. And then on the reverse, it's just this pretty geometric kind of Aztec style print. And so again, you can use completely contrasting fabrics. You can coordinate them like I did. You can do double prints like I did on some. The minky dot with the fleece is always a gorgeous combo. And so this one's my daughter. You saw mine and my son's. This one is my husband, because I told you guys yesterday he runs hot. So I did his single ply. This is my son's. Just his lap one. And then this one here is just an extra one. My daughter's boyfriend might be visiting us over the break. And these are his college colors. He goes to college down in Atlanta with my daughter. And so I'm probably going to give this to him. He can use this when we're hanging out in the theater. And then he can take this with him. So that is my Vlogmas Day 3 sewing project. These are wonderful, quick, and easy gift ideas. Now that I whip these up so quickly, whip some more up over the weekend, because I can include them in my gifts that I need to mail off for my family that will include some napkins and some spices. Now, before I go, I just want to show you a few more blankets that I've made. I sell things in a separate Etsy shop where I sell my handmade goods. And these are some blankets that I'm going to be listing in there. Let me just show them because they might inspire you to think about some other fabric combos. Hang on. Okay, friends, so here's some ones I want to show you just to give you some inspiration in case you want to make some gifts for Christmas, for the holidays. I have strings everywhere. This is real. This is life. These are some that I'm going to be adding to my Etsy shop. It's a popular item to sell, actually. Because babies go through, like, it's not that they go through, but you just need a lot of blankets somehow when you have babies and toddlers. So I'll show you here, you can combine different kinds of fabrics. So this one here is one where I combined a quilter's cotton and then a Sherpa kind of teddy bear fleece on the other side. That's always like warm and cozy for babies, for toddlers, very comforting. And here's one again with that same Sherpa and a different quilter's cotton fabric. This one has a cute flannel print on one side and then a cotton Sherpa kind of fabric on the other. And then this final one here is two layers of cotton flannel. And so here I want to make the point, when you're working with 100% cotton fabrics like this, and especially when you're mixing fabrics, you want to do that same thing that I mentioned in yesterday's Vlogmas video. Pre-wash your fabric. Polyester knit fabrics, they're going to shrink differently than 100% cotton fabrics. And so you don't want to sew it together and wash it, because what's going to happen is that one side that's cotton is going to shrink more than the side that's polyester. And then you're going to have a wonky, weird looking blanket that doesn't sit well. And then remember what I told you also, that sometimes the fabrics do not shrink kind of symmetrically. And so you might get some like warping when it shrinks. So the fabric may not end up being square when you wash it. And it'll be very noticeable if you don't wash the fabric, sew it together, and then wash it. And so you definitely wanna pre-wash and pre-dry your fabrics and then sew them together, okay? So these four that I just showed you were all sewn with that same method, like you do the two-ply napkins. Lay your fabrics on top of each other, right sides facing, trim it down, pin it, leave an opening that you don't sew close so you can turn it right side out, turn that thing right side out, push out those corners. With these, I definitely, you wanna iron them because they're, you know, they're cotton. And then with these, I like to sew from the cotton side, with the cotton side facing up. When it's cotton and cotton, it doesn't matter, pick one. And with the fleece, it doesn't matter, just pick one. Then these last two I wanna show you, I actually made upon the similar vein, but with these I actually quilted them. But it's kind of the same principle. This one is a little bit more intricate, right? Because I did the binding, which you can do also on these quilts if you want to make binding. So this is just, and what I did with these is I actually put, I sandwiched a layer of cotton batting in between. And I'm sharing this with you guys because if you'd like for me to do a tutorial during Vlogmas showing you how to make a really simple quilt like this, let me know. This is really, really, you know, it doesn't have all the patchwork. This is like a whole cloth quilt and you can put these together so quickly. So if you're interested in that, let me know and I'll see if I can add that into one of the Vlogmas plans that I already have. And then here, this one is done the same way as I talked before, with the two sides facing together. On that wrong side that's facing up, I put the batting down so that it was, you know, would be sandwiched in there. Then I turned it right side out and then I simply top stitch and did these quilting squares. So it looks like a quilty quilt, but it's kind of a cheater quilt. And they come together really nicely. And I do this because there's some prints where I feel like I don't want it all chopped up into little pieces. Like this is so graphic. So the way I did it, you can still see the trees. You can see all the big flowers. Where if you did a patchwork quilt, I mean, you would be cutting this all up and you wouldn't see it. And then the same thing with the chevron. I mean, if you chop that all up, it wouldn't look like chevron anymore, right? And so this is a great way when you have those like real showcase pieces. This is a Tamis, what's Tamis's last name? Oh, I'll put it on the screen. Oh yeah, is it Kiev? I think it's Tamis Kiev. I'll put it on the screen. He's a very, very famous mid-century modern designer. And one of the quilting companies got licensed to print some of his famous prints that were printed on bark cloth. And you know, I snatched those up and most of them are sold out. I actually have a few Christmas prints. Maybe I'll put those in the fabric shop. But anyway, look at this. I mean, I couldn't cut that up, right? You can still see all the doggies. Nobody's head or tail is cut off, but it's still quilted. And of course I paired it with this like Dalmatian print. So this is really fun. So anyway, guys, that's it for the show and tell. Let me pop off and do a proper bye-bye to you guys. Okay, friends, well, that is it today. I hope you liked today's project for Vlogmas Day 3 over here on Cherie's Alchemy. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you just want to chat, let me know what you think about these. Let me know if you have any blankets on your gift sewing plans for 2021. I would love to hear and have a conversation with you guys in the comment box of the video. Please also know that I would love for you to take the moment, if you're watching this and you haven't yet subscribed, here's your invitation. We would love for you to join us on the channel. Make sure you hit that notification bell and hit the bell so that it marks all, because I'm going to be uploading daily during Vlogmas and you don't want to miss anything. It is my birthday month. It's the month of Christmas and all the holidays. And so I'm going to be sprinkling in little giveaways throughout Vlogmas and you don't want to miss any. If you're catching day 3 and it is not yet December the 8th, then you do have time to go to my Vlogmas day 1 and enter that giveaway. And you could get some fabric to make your own blankets, okay? All right, guys, I thank you so much for watching. I have to get dinner in the oven and do a little hangout time with my boys. But I look forward to seeing you guys here tomorrow. All right, stay well.